This is the Dutch International Service. Feedback.
Radio Netherlands Saturday Listener Contact Program.
This edition is presented by Neville Gray. And hello again, and welcome to this week's edition of the program, which answers your questions and plays some of your music requests. Although we have so many cards and letters coming in asking all sorts of questions, we're a bit pushed for time to play music. But we'll see what we can do today, seeing as how it's nearly Christmas.
I have been listening to your broadcasts for about a year and a half now, and I find them very interesting. I especially like your critical reporting of the international situation. That you do a far better job on that score than the other major national radio services.
Kind words from Robert Bell, a listener at Isla Vista in California, USA, and we thank you. And how about this one for a story with a happy ending?
The DX hobby has helped me to have a romance. In 1974, I listened just on the right day to Radio Kuwait's English program when they announced the wish of Maurice Horreau from the Seychelles to receive a pen pal. I wrote to Maurice 1 year later when I found the notice with his name again, but he didn't answer me. Instead of him, his sister, Maurice Horreau, found the letter. And in 1976, I received her first letter. We had been pen pals till 1981, when she came as an au pair girl to Remseck, close to Stuttgart. She came to Saarbrücken in July 1981, the first time. And since last December, she came every second weekend. Now we fell in love. And on October 29th, we had our civil marriage. The marriage ceremony in our Protestant church will be on December the 11th. You see, the shortwave hobby has made it possible.
A letter from Volker Wilschri of Saarbrücken-Breibach in the Federal Republic of Germany. And I must say, we're very pleased and happy for you both and hope that today is a very happy wedding day there in Saarbrücken-Breibach. And thank you for letting us know about it. You're tuned to Shortwave Feedback from Radio Netherlands. And with Christmas so close, the annual Christmas records are starting to appear. Last week on St. Nicholas, we played a Sinterklaas song, so this week it's Christmas in every way. A Christmas song from a man called Christmas, Mr. Gary Christmas, an American Blackfoot Indian who lives and works here in Holland, and his reworking of the old Christmas favorite, Jingle Bells.
Hello.
Christmas speaking.
Hi, sir. Christmas. Can I come over tonight?
Can you come over tonight? No way, woman!
Ring them bells, those funky bells.
Ring them all the way. Oh, I find it out of sight if I cannot stay. Hit those
bells, ring them all the way.
Oh, I find it out of sight if I cannot stay.
Can I ring you low? Cause this is the only way. Baby, don't you know? You can dance it all the way. Turn you on or make you feel all right. I tell you a little thing, it's cold out there tonight. Yeah, ring those bells, ring them all the way.
Oh, I'm out of sight if I can make you stay.
Hit those bells,
ring them all the way. Oh, I'm out of sight if I can.
As the snow falls down, so let us dance around. Grooving on those swinging sounds, turned up real loud. It's funky and it's me. It's cheerful and it's bright. So turn this dance to a dream and boogie all night.
Ring them all the way. Ring them all the way.
Oh, my body's not right if I can let you stay.
Ring them all the way.
If I can
stay. A little drop of Christmas music on shortwave feedback from Mr. Gary Christmas and his funky jingle bells.
Thanks for another year of excellent programs. I'd always wondered why there were so many Dutchmen in New Zealand. Now I know why. They come here to listen to your shortwave broadcast.
Thank you, Lance Andrews of Motu Acre in New Zealand, for the card and good wishes. But if you recall from last week's program, Will van der Fluet was in the midst of answering a few questions from a listener in Sweden when we ran out of time. So let's welcome Will back to the program and see where we got to with Per Arvidsson's questions.
Hello, I'm Per Arvidsson from Stockholm, Sweden. I'd like to ask the Radio Netherlands team, are there any twin towns between Sweden or even Stockholm and the Netherlands, any twin towns? That's all I'd like to ask you. So, Per Arvidsson, Stockholm, Sweden, goodbye.
Will, can you help there too?
Twinning is an initiative taken some 30 years ago by a body called the Raad der Europese Gemeenten. In English, that is the Council of European Municipalities. The purpose of it is to foster European integration. Now I've gone into this thing a little bit more deeply, and I find that there are some, I think, more than 250, 260 municipalities in the Netherlands that have twin towns overseas. And they don't restrict themselves, you know, to Europe. I mean, even I find that when we were doing the program, the bicentennial of 200 years of diplomatic and friendly relations between the Netherlands and the United States, we found that, for example, there was also a twin town, Enschede, I think it was, with Memphis in the United States. Mm-hmm. Now, I must disappoint Per, for as regards Stockholm, there is no twin town in the Netherlands that is twinning with Stockholm. However, there are two places in the Netherlands that are twinning with the towns in Sweden. And if you have a map of Europe, you might be able to find the Dutch towns. The Dutch town of Meppel is twinning with Oskarshamn. Oskarshamn in Sweden, and the village of Vledder, Vledder, is twinning with a place called Jokkmokk. Now, I hope I pronounce it correctly, but I'll spell it for you. It is Yokkmokk. Now, as a matter of fact, most municipalities in the Netherlands that are part of this twinning system support it by giving subsidies which range from about 1,500 to 250,000 guilders per year, depending on the size of the town or city, which amounts to about 25 cents to one guilder per capita of Dutch population. Now, a lot of initiatives are taking this. For example, in one case, twinning resulted in local bodies making available free of charge to residents in the town involved access to camping sites, swimming pools, and other facilities. Of course, this makes for an economically attractive arrangement in the service sectors of both countries, or both towns, rather. Now, the purpose of twinning, as I've said, are to foster European integration. Other accessory or additional purposes are that to foster common objectives that might be in these places, to foster friendship between nations, and to foster or promote cultural exchanges. One aspect I should mention, the twinning between French and German towns started soon after World War II. It has been a great success, despite the war, and, of course, I mean, in the last World War, where German and France were antagonists, and the language barrier. So I think this particular initiative is indeed bearing fruit on a grassroots scale, you know. I think this system does work.
So, Per Arvidsson, there's your answer.
May I make a suggestion? Why not have a monthly contest for best letter of the month and or best question? Prizes such as a picture book of Holland could be offered.
A card and a suggestion from Alan Rising of Poway, California. And what do you think about that suggestion, Will?
Excellent suggestion. And I think you are getting a bit of work put on your shoulders there, Neville. Because if we are going to select the best letter of the month, I'm going to look to you to do that. So, what do you think about it?
I think it's a good idea.
Okay.
Something for 1983.
It's done. We're going to do it. I have a few points to make. One regarding who would listen to classical music on shortwave. Well, two groups of people, radio nuts like me, and those people living in out-of-the-way places in the world, of which I have been both. I love all kinds of music, Beethoven, Mozart, rock, popular, but sometimes I can't relate to the music on your station. The people of the U.S. have a great friendship for the people in Holland. And your radio station brings our two countries closer together. The closer our two peoples are, the greater the chances of world peace and no nuclear war.
A nice letter and sentiments from Nick Norris of Berkeley, California, USA. Would you care to comment?
Yes. This question of playing music on shortwave has bothered me, has really occupied me. I've had many letters from people saying, why don't you play classical music? Now, I have, as arguments, I have advanced that the quality, the hi-fi quality of the original recording doesn't really carry on shortwave because of the frequency spectrum that is available. However, if the pressure from people abroad is so great that they want to hear classical music, look, I will certainly start discussing this with our program director.
You're tuned to Holland. This is Radio Netherlands.
Why is the Netherlands so down on South Africa? You report any matter which seems to be detrimental to South Africa. But just as much goes on in the rest of the world, which is detrimental to the rights of the individual.
A letter from where else? South Africa, from A.C. Sargent of Rondebos, Cape Town. Will?
Yes, very difficult question. We report, if you listen to our broadcasts regularly, you'll find that the question South Africa is only one part of our transmissions. But on the other hand, whenever something occurs in South Africa, you should realize that we are broadcasting to try and represent and reflect public opinion in the Netherlands. And why the Dutch are so much against South Africa, I don't know. They are against apartheid. They are not against South Africans. I mean, the same thing applies to some people have accused us sometimes of being anti-American. I've been in extensive correspondence with quite a few high-ranking people in the United States, and I've explained to them that it is not a question of being anti-American in person, but there are certain aspects of policy which run contrary to our ideas. Less than 1 week ago, I was in Holland on vacation. While in Nijmegen, I looked over a large color program describing the Delta Plan. Do you know where I might write to obtain one, preferably in English? But Dutch is okay.
From Lawrence Grobau of Yuba City, California. We're sending you a pamphlet on the Delta Plan and the address of its information center, so watch out for those in the mail. I would like to say hello at this point to H. Vivekanand, a regular listener in Jainagar, Bangalore, India, and glad to hear that you're enjoying the programs. I hope that you've received the cards and stickers that you requested. Hello also to Rahul K. Nayak of Baroda in Gujarat State, India, and also hello to Andrew Turnbull of French's Forest in Sydney, Australia.
I think shortwave feedback is a very good program, as it has a very large variety of interesting items.
We'd like to say thank you to Ebenezer Agyei of Kaduna, Nigeria, for your very nice Christmas card, and to say hello from Ebenezer to Joyce van Tau and her husband in Steenstraat in Utrecht, and play a nice record. Well, I hope you like this one from Peter Schneider, and it's called Love is a Cabaret.
Everywhere I
Dutch singer Peter Schneider, who'll be a guest in a Talking To program shortly. And that's the title track from his latest album. You heard it on Shortwave Feedback.
I am a keen and regular listener to all your programs to Africa. I must confess here and now that the quality of your program is high. Your news is broad-based and always very comprehensive. And the reception of your station here in Nigeria is good. Your news is always very educative, and your musical programs very entertaining.
Compliments will get you anywhere. A letter from Dixon Uo Okpe of the government secondary school in Hadejia, I think it is, Kanu State in Nigeria. Thank you for your letter.
Please excuse my writing to you in English. I imagine that you find it to be quite presumptuous of us Americans to assume that everybody can understand our language. I spent several years singing opera in Germany, and my sister and her husband still reside in the city of Harlem. While I understand quite a bit of Dutch, my German creeps into my writing and speaking. And I approvingly acknowledge how you feel about your neighbors to the east, Duitsers. I look forward to receiving as much information as you have available. Further, I anticipate being in Holland this coming spring. When my dates become more specific, I'll write to ask permission to visit your studios in Hilversum. As one who has listened to your broadcast for years and years, I look forward to seeing the facility sometime soon.
A letter from John C. Dunbar of Chino, California. Thanks, John, and we look forward to seeing you next year in Hilversum. I'd like to take this opportunity, though, of inviting you to call in your Christmas greetings for our special Christmas Day edition of Shortwave Feedback, which will be broadcast on the 25th. But get those calls in early if you want to be included in the program. How better to send Christmas greetings than via Shortwave Feedback? Call us on our direct line. That's international code 31 for Holland, 35 for Hilversum, and then the number is 1-877-00, and you have 90 seconds in which to leave your special Christmas greetings for our Christmas Day edition of Shortwave Feedback.
Could you please broadcast some information about Dutch trade with Scotland, which I have heard was extensive in the 16th, 17th, and 18th centuries, and in particular, trade with my home county of Fife. Most textbooks just mention it in passing, as both countries were so often fighting the old enemy, England.
A letter from Alan Forbes of Kirkcaldy in Fife, and perhaps, Will, you'd like to comment.
You caught me on the hop here. I'm sorry, I know that there was extensive trade, and as our letter writer says, the trade, he didn't find much information in textbooks. I have just had a quick look at a few textbooks, and I can't find, but I'll study the matter further, and I hope to come back to this matter either in Shortwave Feedback or in report, in our report program.
We are desirous of getting information about the running and management of nursery and pre-primary schools in your country. Would very much appreciate your sending us literature, posters, etc. that will help our venture.
A letter from Mrs. Padmagopan of the Bopdale Kindergarten in a place called Karapuza, Kottayam. But unfortunately, you didn't mention the country. But the letter goes on.
Bopdale is the name of the nursery school we are running in our small town. We believe childhood and adolescence are the decisive periods in the formation of an individual's character and capacity. And so we stressed in the curriculum for developing creative abilities of the young ones. The essential features which form the human character are similar all over the world, and hence we think we may use information on the subject from other countries. Hence this letter.
It might be interesting to speculate just what country it does come from, Will.
Yes, indeed. I would like to ask the letter writer, if she happens or he happens to listen in to this program, to let us know what country it is, because I'm quite prepared to send some literature. I am sure it is available, but I only want to know where to send it.
A reminder that this is Shortwave Feedback from Radio Netherlands.
Just a note to tell you, I've moved from Boston on the East Coast to San Diego on the West Coast. I'm pleased to say that just like an old friend, Radio Netherlands is here as strong and reliable as ever. You make a new city feel just like home. Thanks for always being there.
Thanks to Alan Rising for that card from Poway in California. And thanks also to you, Will, for those answers. And I hope we'll see you again next week.
Oh, I'm quite happy to come back. Thank you.
My name is John Berry, and I'm living in Walnut Creek, California, in the United States. And my question for your program what is the most popular sport in the Netherlands?
Well, John, the man to ask about sport is sporting editor Henny Rukert.
The most popular sport in the Netherlands is football.
That's what the British people would call soccer.
Soccer, yes.
Mm-hmm. Why is it the most popular?
I don't know. I think it's a sport of the people.
By most popular, do you mean also as a spectator sport or more people play it as well?
Both ways. Spectator sports as well participants. We have more than a million soccer players in Holland. And each weekend, I suppose, about 100,000 people are going to look only to the professional soccer matches. And then the amateurs that will go between 1,000 to 3,500 people a game.
So the professional, of course, is the one that most people watch. How many teams in the National League are there?
We have in the national team 18 teams, and in the second division we have 17.
Well, everybody's heard of the two major Dutch professional soccer teams, Ajax Amsterdam and Feyenoord from Rotterdam, but there are lots of other fairly well-known ones too.
Yeah, there are very other well-known teams, but for an example, it's very nice to hear, I suppose, that last weekend we had a topper in the Dutch soccer association. It was Ajax against Feyenoord. It was in Rotterdam in the Feyenoord stadium. There were 63,000 spectators. But I suppose 150,000 will see the match. It was a tremendous game. It ended 2-2, and Ajax was technical better. Feyenoord worked harder. Feyenoord missed an elf meter, 20 minutes four time. It is an unforgettable game. And you know, Johan Cruyff is playing with Ajax. Willem van Hanegem is playing with Feyenoord. But 18 years ago, they played also in Ajax and Feyenoord against each other. It's very nice, I think.
That was a nice return match.
Yeah, that was it without thinking. Mm-hmm. The third well-known team in Holland is PSV. Mm-hmm. After the match, 2-2, Ajax-Feyenoord, the three teams, PSV, Ajax and Feyenoord, are together in top of the first division. They played 15 games and all have 24 points. And only the goal scorers of PSV from Eindhoven is better than the other two. PSV 40 goals, Ajax 37 and Feyenoord 32.
Talking about it internationally though, we were not represented this year for the World Cup. What was the reason for that? In a word.
I will know the reason, but I don't know. It's gone less better than in 78 when we were in the World Championships. The new coach of the Dutch team tried to put in some young players, but they are not doing so good. They miss a leader, and now the next game is on the 19th of December in Aachen, Germany, against Malta. It's a classification match for the European Championships. Mm-hmm. And now he asked back several old players like Ruud Krol, Hugo Hovenkamp and Kees van Kooten, and maybe with these old players the team will be a good team.
What do you expect will be the result?
Hard to know.
Sporting editor Henny Rukert. You're tuned to Holland.
That's my
feedback. And I'd like to say hello to Karen Watterson of Trinity, North Carolina, and say thank you for your letter. Thanks also to David Mtambi of Kampala, Uganda, and I wish I could help you in obtaining that new radio, but of course we can't, but I do hope that you're able to arrange one soon.
My name is Joseph Hughes. I'm calling from Boston, Massachusetts, USA. December 8th, marks the tragic death of John Lennon, one of the great, if not the greatest, Beatles. And I would like you to play a song by John Lennon to commemorate his life, his great works, and his memory and love. Thank you.
Thank you.
voice of the late John Lennon, and indeed, earlier this week, it was the anniversary of his death. Goodness me, this year has just flown, like all of them, hasn't it? Hello, and thank you to Mr. B. Sadler of Ashford in Kent
for your letter,
and I'm glad you're enjoying the programmes. Greetings also to Rainer Matsunski of Tierschenreuth in West Germany. Thank you for your letter. And as regards your question about what is the public opinion in Holland regarding the plan or the final decision of the common market to cut all imports of seal products, I'm pleased to say that the mainstream of public opinion here in the Netherlands is very much in favour of banning all seal products, and we were all delighted generally with the decision to ban them. It was, incidentally, an Anglo-Dutch initiative in the Euro Parliament. Hello to David Jacques Feeder of New York. I'm sorry if you think there's sometimes bias and dishonesty in our approach to certain subjects. I assure you this is not the case, and I think perhaps you should listen a little more closely to the various reports and interviews, and you'd find this to be the case.
Hello, my name is Jay Reed. I live in Louisville, Kentucky, in the United States of America. I'd like to say that I really like your programs, and that I really enjoy Media Network and the Monday Report and the Wednesday Report. I've been listening to you for almost a year now, and you were the first shortwave station I ever picked up. I'd like to know these questions, the answers to these questions, I'm sorry. Do you have a shortwave club? I'd also like you to please send me some of your books on how to get the most out of your receiver. Thank you very much from the United States of America. I'm Jay Reese.
Thanks, Jay, for your call. No, we don't have a shortwave listeners club. That's the short answer, and we will indeed send you the other thing. Hello there to Selwyn Milton de Souza of Parel, Bombay, India, and thank you for your card.
I must say, Radio Netherlands programs are well presented and provide a wealth and variety of information which listeners would like to know.
And your program
enables listeners to get to know more about topics not covered by the other programs. Radio Netherlands broadcasting team is doing a fine job. Do keep it up.
I'm afraid time has beaten us. It's time to say goodbye until next Saturday, the week before Christmas. And may I take this opportunity again of inviting you to call in your Christmas greetings for our special Christmas Day edition of Shortwave Feedback. Get those calls in early if you want to be included in the program. How better to send Christmas greetings than via Shortwave Feedback. Thanks to all those taking part today, especially John Hammond, who read the letters, and sound engineer Michel Plemperer. Till next time, Neville Gray saying goodbye from Holland.